Hello friends. So in the previous video, I had introduced you with the simple techniques or the historical methods for building load calculations. And I introduced you with the four methods, the first one of which was degree day method. So in this video, we'll be covering with the details of degree day method. And it's going to be very simple concept, not so tricky, not so useful in these days in industry, but the importance is because this was the earliest method develops, we need to understand how the development of these techniques of building load calculation has developed over the years. So we just need to know what formulas it used, what assumptions it took place, what were the advantages, disadvantages, but it's not important to go and solve questions and practice solving these questions for exams now. It's not required. And for your understanding, this DD is very important. We understand the degree day method because DD, the short form has been used extensively right now, even from, because it is the very basic one and the degree days are recorded historically. What the degree days mean, I'll explain you in shortly, but still we do refer to the measurements of temperature in terms of degree days in some locations. So these are important. So very basic, we'll start with the formulas which are used. The first one understanding is the degree days. So the degree day means is equal to DD is equal to TI minus, so obviously this I goes to the subscript, minus T balance plus or T balance minus TI plus. Now what's the difference? So I hope you remember that what this positive sign means. It simply means that for this factor, I'll take only the positive values. If this factor turns out to be negative, then we'll assign the value to be zero. And similarly for this, if the T balance is greater than TI, we'll have a value. If T balance is less than TI in this case, then the value turns out to be zero automatically. And this indicates that my T indoor is greater than T balance, and that means my indoor has to be a greater temperature than T balance basically represents the outside temperature. So my T indoor is going to be greater than T balance. That means I need heating. And in case of T balance greater than TI, that means the outside temperature is greater than T internal temperature. That means my internal temperature is less and hence I'm cooling my home. So this formula basically indicates heating degree days, which is H heating degree days. Well, this formula basically indicates, cooling degree days, CDD, which means cooling and degree days. Right now, I hope you understood, and I definitely remember explaining you the concept of T balance, which means the T balance is an outside temperature. It's not an indoor temperature. It's an outside temperature at which the room, the indoors or the building doesn't require heating or cooling. That means the outside temperature is such that the amount of heat gain in the building is exactly equal to the amount of heat loss from the building. So the heat loss and heat gains balance out and there is no requirement of heating or cooling. That means if my temperature indoor is greater than that balance temperature, I need a heating. Balance temperature is greater than the internal temperature, I need cooling. Now, the degree day method, what it helps us to obviously estimate the amount of heat loads or the heating load. So it gives us the building heating estimate which is represented as Q H heating which is equal to 24 times H, and I'll explain all these terminologies in a while, into DD, which is the degree days. Obviously, heating degree days, if it is, we are going to be heating estimate. If it is a cooling estimate, then we'll use the CDDs, divided by TI minus T out. And this is again equal to efficiency of my boiler into Q of my fuel used, right? So efficiency of my boiler, this is the boiler efficiency. And Q fuel, this term is basically equal to, basically means boiler fuel energy. That means the calorific value of the fuel which we are using. H, let me just write down everything which is simple. H is equal to heating required in 1 hour. So this is hourly basis because it is all on basis of imperial units, and we can easily convert everything to the SI units also. T out is the design outdoor temperature. T in is the inside temperature. And it will be equal to 65. That's the balance temperature which we want inside our room. And H, obviously I said it is the calculated heat loss of building. So it is required heating is equal to heat loss. So whatever heat is lost should be compensated by heating. Heat loss. So I hope you have understood the very basics of it. We never want to go into the details and solving questions of the very simple techniques, but the advantage of this method is that we only need the weather data, that means the outdoor temperature data, that's all. We do not need anything else, no information about how the home is and everything. We can just take estimates of it. And it also provides very simple and easy calculations. It's a very simple formula to get the average heating or cooling required. But the disadvantage is that there is no part load. So the boiler always operates at the given efficiency. If my loads reduce, the boiler efficiency is not changing, which is not true. Depending on the load, the boiler efficiency changes actually. But this formula doesn't take into account these changes in the part loads condition. And also we are assuming the constant balance temperature of 65 degrees Celsius. This temperature is 65 degrees Celsius, which is constant. But obviously it depends on the location, the comfort requirements, the internal heat gains and all. There are a lot of factors, the technical things which are there inside this T balance, and we'll take into account and see all the details of T balance later. But this is one of the disadvantage. And it very much indirectly takes into account the internal loads, because usually the comfort temperature inside the room is not 65, it would be some 72 or 75 degree Fahrenheit. But to balance out those some internal gains, we are taking 65 degree Fahrenheit. And also we are not zoning our building into multiple different zones which exist in the building. This is a single zone assumption. So these are some of the disadvantages, and that's all we have with respect to degree day method. In the next video, we'll take into account the way modified degree day method, which takes into account a couple of more factors, and we'll be able to overcome some disadvantages of this method of degree days. Thank you.